Alright, so this is a pretty obscure racing game for the Game Boy Advance. It's called Monster Truck Madness. Now, I have played Monster Truck Madness on my channel in the past, not this particular port. I did a video on the original PC release of Monster Truck Madness 2 back in 2015, and to put it simply, it was a racing game featuring monster trucks. You know, the ones with those incredibly jacked up suspensions and those insane paint schemes, the ones that people will actually pay money to watch them brutally steamroll a bunch of innocent vehicles underneath their gigantic ass all-terrain wheels. Yeah, I'm talking about those big boys, of course. It was a game that I used to love playing when I was an incredibly young child. At one point, it was even one of my most favorite racing games of all time, although my opinions on it have kind of changed now. To be honest, it's not the best racing game ever, nor is it the most fun, in my opinion. But in all fairness, there weren't really that many racing games out there, if any at all, that allowed you to race one of these badass vehicles through the open wilderness. At least there weren't that many of those games back in 1996, so you could say it's kind of unique for its time. But something that I don't believe I mentioned in my MTM2 video is that the Monster Truck Madness games did receive ports to some of Nintendo's platforms, which is highly unusual for a Microsoft-published game, but it did receive a port to the Nintendo 64. That one was simply titled Monster Truck Madness 64. The N64 port was actually published by Rockstar Games, which is pretty interesting. That port came out in 1999, and then in 2003, the game got a handheld port to the Game Boy Advance. So finally, you could take Monster Truck Madness on the go with you. But the question is, how well did this game translate from the home computer to a 32-bit handheld system? Well, it translated pretty decently, I would say, but there are a few issues I have with it, a few very glaring issues. Alright, so here we are in the main menu. Now, how exactly does the Game Boy Advance port differ from the PC versions? Well, the main menu is completely different, obviously. I should mention that this port of Monster Truck Madness was not made by Terminal Reality, who are the developers of the PC Monster Truck Madness games. This was developed by a studio called Tantalus Media. So the first thing that you may have noticed here is that there is no multiplayer mode. Of course, the PC Monster Truck Madness games had a multiplayer mode. As a matter of fact, you could play them online with other people. Not sure if it's possible to do that now, considering those games came out like 20 years ago, but still, the online multiplayer was definitely there. And also, don't expect any of the tracks from the PC game to be ported over here, because none of them have. All of the tracks in this game are brand new, and the selection this time around is actually somewhat smaller. This is a single-player only racing game, even though those don't really exist anymore. As a matter of fact, those racing games pretty much stopped existing by the time this came out. I mean, this was in 2003. And not only that, but some Game Boy Advance racing games by this time had multiplayer in them, like Mario Kart Super Circuit had it. That came out 2 years prior to this. So that's one huge letdown right off the bat. Of course, the music is completely different, and personally, I do not like the music in the GBA version at all. I prefer the PC version's music over GBA any time of the day, or any day of the week for that matter. It's not that bad though, just a little bit repetitive for my liking. Now, you still have all of the trucks, or most of the trucks from the PC games, like you have Carolina Crusher, Executioner, Bulldozer, Monster Patrol. Something that is new here is that the other trucks are locked. Now, I'm not entirely sure how to unlock them. I only played this, like, a little bit off-screen, and I figured out how I'm supposed to unlock the tracks, because most of them are locked as well. But some of the locked vehicles include Gravedigger, Nightmare, Mad Dog, Bearclaw, Scorpion, and Carnivore. And I don't think most of those were even in Monster Truck Madness 2. I know that Nightmare was, but the other four, I don't remember ever seeing, so I assume they're exclusive to this port, perhaps? And each monster truck has their own stats and attributes, like speed, acceleration, suspension, and weight, which is vastly different from the PC version, in which all of the trucks just perform the exact same. You can also see that the trucks are fully textured 3D models, so this is another one of these, like, 3D GBA games that really tries to push the portable system's hardware to its limits. So this port has 10 tracks in total. We have Raceway, Lost City, Sandy Bay, Docklands, Downtown, Mesa Valley, Panorama, Off-Pist, Dirt Bowl, and Junkyard. The only ones that are unlockable from the start are Raceway, Mesa Valley, and Dirt Bowl. You can unlock more tracks by simply competing in races and getting first place. The only ones I'm gonna bother with in this video are the ones we already have available to us. So to better demonstrate how the game plays, I'm gonna go to Circuit first. The time to beat is 1 minute and 57 seconds. And there's also three different difficulties, but what's kind of strange is that you have to unlock the more difficult versions of the tracks, because, like, that's kind of the weird thing. You can't actually select the difficulty in this game. If you want to play any of these tracks on, like, intermediate or the hardest mode possible, you have to unlock those versions of the tracks, because they count as, like, separate tracks for some reason, and that's really strange, and I don't understand it whatsoever. But anyway, yeah, welcome to Monster Truck Madness on the Game Boy Advance, and, yeah, that's actually kind of cool, the thing that appears at the very start. You have, like, a play-in, and it's flying around the track, and you have to outspeed it, or you have to try and outrun it, because like there's a little line moving along the track, and it's basically showing you it basically shows you how well you're doing. Like if you're past the line, then that means you're en route to beating the best time and setting a brand new record. So you use the D-pad to move around, and you can also press the A button. This is also pretty cool too, because when you're driving around on the dirt, yeah, you actually get dirt on your truck. That's pretty cool. They are all fully fledged 3D models. Oh god, I have no idea why, but every time I go around these turns right here, the way that it scales some of the sprites in this game are definitely really strange, and it does feel like you're staring at an optical illusion at times, especially when you're going around those bends. It's really weird. It looks like the background is moving, but the track is not, and it just messes with my brain. So, this game uses a combination of 3D models and 2D sprites. Most of the environmental objects that you can collide with, like these barriers right here, yeah, they are just 2D sprites. Oh god, I'm going off the track. Oh god, crane, get out of my way! Holy crap! Okay, yeah. So, yeah, some of these are destructible, and the other ones, like the giant-ass cranes, are not. And actually, I don't think... Oh, yeah, oh no, these tiny cars are destructible. You get, like, a bit of a bounce off of them. Yeah, and then when you win the race, your truck just, like, jumps for joy somehow. I'm pretty sure that's not even physically possible to make the truck bounce like that. Like, almost vertically 90 degrees in the air without, like, flipping over. Gotta be a true master of your craft to accomplish that significant feat. You know what, just because that passed by a little bit too quickly, I'm actually gonna go back to, the raceway for just a moment. Yeah, and there are different types of races here as well. You also have, rally races, which just involves getting to all the checkpoints. It's like a one-lap race. Yeah, so you see that play-in above, and you have to try and outrun it in the time trial mode, because you're just trying to set the best lap time. You only race one lap, and then after that, it's over. And on the much shorter tracks, it tends to end extremely quickly. The physics are definitely a lot wonkier in this port of the game, though, because this one doesn't utilize, like, actual real-world physics modeling, unlike the PC versions of the game. And what kind of sucks is that you can't roll over your trucks in this game, because you could in the PC version because it had, like, full physics modeling. So everything was pretty much affected by gravity, and even when you're going over these jumps right here, like, you can kind of get some air. It almost feels like gravity is a lot stronger in this game, though, because you can't really jump off the bumps as high as you can in the PC version. Like, you can't get as much big air as you can in those versions of the game. Something just seems really off about the physics here, and I don't expect it to have, like, full physics modeling anyway. Like, I don't expect this to use an actual physics engine, because this is Game Boy Advance we're talking about here. I'm not sure if like, actual physics modeling was something that the GBA was capable of, like, actually being able to utilize a true physics model or, like, a physics engine, like, I don't know, Havoc physics, for instance. Oh god, I hit the same friggin' crane again. Are you kidding me? Wait, where even is the plane? I'm not even trying to beat my best time, but I just did again. So, hooray for not trying, but still succeeding. Something that they did manage to carry over from the original are the damage models. So when your truck collides with an object, it still gets damaged. Although, much like the PC version, that doesn't actually affect the performance of your truck. Unlike the PC version, though, there is no button to reset the damage models. Yeah, unfortunately, you won't be finding that many hotkeys in this game. In fact, all of the hotkeys are pretty much non-existent. So I think next I'll choose, Monster Patrol here. I'll probably try going going to... I actually want to go to Dirt Bowl in particular. So there are various forms of terrain that you can race on, much like the PC games. Dirt in particular is almost impossible to control because you might as well be attempting to drive your truck on black ice. Like, it's nearly impossible to control. I mean, and look at this, for goodness sakes. Like, I'm trying to stay within the track here, but it just swerves all over the place, and it's really hard to keep the damn truck away from the wall. It just bounces all over the place, and it's almost impossible. Like, there's so many, like, tiny bumps everywhere. Not only that, but given the way that the track renders, even that can throw you off sometimes, because they definitely try it with the 3D modeling here, but sometimes it just looks... It looks really strange at times. Like, I'm trying to look at an optical illusion here, and yeah, there's also exploding barrels. It's not different from the PC version, though, because in those versions, there were also various objects you could collide with. You could destroy fences, for instance, and those were all, like, modeled with physics, that is. Oh yeah, I really like that, too, when you're breaking the taillights light up. I'm not sure if you were able to see that, but I was doing that before the race began. I decided to restart this, because this is by far the shortest track, or at least the shortest track that is already unlocked to us. Are you serious? Okay, I'm not sure if you guys could hear that, but I'm actually recording this at, like, 12:30 in the morning. Some douche outside is literally gunning his sports car down the road at like Mach 5 outside. Like, you could actually hear the engine, like the engine roaring. And you know what really pisses me off? It's pretty much the same guy who always does that at like this time at night, just cruising down the road. Like, not even the highway. Like, we're on like a public road here. Well, I know that highways are like public roads. What the heck is even happening on the game anyway? Like, I can't even tell where I'm going. Like, all the terrain is just this. Oh! Well, alright. I guess that's, like, another, like, ending pose? Okay, I thought for a moment that rollovers were actually possible. But yeah, and the way I know that it's the same person is that it's always, like, around this time at night, like, after midnight, and he's just blazing down the freeway, like, waking up everyone with his obnoxiously loud engine. Pretty much the same thing that every freaking motorcyclist does when they come down this road, or just every motorcyclist in general. You're doing this in an urban area, dude, like... Calm your tits. You don't need to be revving the RPM of your engine to like 10 million in an urban area at like 12:30 at night. It's almost like you're trying to receive a noise complaint. Anyway, that's all there really is to say about Time Attack in particular. You know, just beat your best time. Time Attack is self-explanatory in like any racing game. That's a pretty cool feature though, the fact that you have to like outrun a plane in Time Attack. If you want to know what instant action does, it just drops you into a race immediately with a random track and a truck. So that's if you just want to dive right into the action immediately. But for now, we're going to go to the race mode, which is the meat of this port. And this is where things are going to get a little bit strange, and you'll see what I mean in just a moment. I am going to go to the rally game mode here. I'd just like to be cruising through some checkpoints. This is just a one-lap race. I'll probably be able to show this here, and also how the game is definitely able to render the other monster trucks on screen. I have no idea what that purple one is. Like I said, this is where things start getting a little bit strange, okay? That mapping there is a little bit strange. Like, that sprite layering is a little bit odd. Well, I mean, these are supposed to be fully texture map 3D models, but it seems like the other trucks just look like sprites, almost. I mean, it's still pretty cool, though. I mean, yeah, because they're not really animating all that much. Yeah, this track is also weird, because it almost seems to have, like, coral on the road. I don't understand what that is, like, silver coral. So, yeah, you have various items that you can pick up. For instance, oh, God, for instance, you have, disappearing sprites. Because apparently there is a sprite limit, or I have the sprite limits enabled here. Too much crap happening on the screen. It's just like a Sega Genesis game, or an NES game, or basically any game that uses sprite. Okay, can you stop colliding with me? Yeah, so you have different power-ups that you can obtain. Good God! How is that guy, like, cruising along at 200 miles per hour? What the heck did he pick up anyway? Also, I like how the roof of my house is all crooked here. Okay, I think I might have just blown everyone up. So, yeah, there's various items that you can collect. You have, like, sticky wheels, like wheels, or, like, an upgrade that makes your wheels a lot stickier. So that way you basically can't jump over any, like, hills. So not really the most exciting one. And I'm not entirely sure what that upgrade is, but I believe that grants me invincibility. And there is one that allows me to blow up all of the other drivers. And basically what that does is that it stuns them temporarily. Like, their engine explodes and they won't be able to move for a short amount of time. That can definitely be useful. And a lot of the power-ups here even remind me of Mario Kart. As a matter of fact, one of the power-ups was stolen directly from Mario Kart. There's a power-up that allows you to shrink the other drivers. Where exactly do you think that comes from? Okay, yeah, this is basically a mushroom. Good God, why do I have so much of a stutter here anyway? I'm sorry, I'm way too excited here, I need to calm down. But yeah, you have like a mushroom-esque power-up that grants you a speed boost. It uses it immediately though. Yeah, because as you can see, you collect all the items, but the game uses it instantly. Oh yeah, and there is also this feature right here called Rampage. So, when you collide with enough objects in this game, or you collide with a certain number of objects, it will actually grant you a massive boost of speed for a few seconds. You'll notice that there's a meter at the bottom of the screen, and when I collide with objects, that meter will fill up. And once the meter fills up completely, then I go into a rampage. Oh yeah, by the way, there's the very stretch-out house. Also, why did I just, like, bounce to the left there? Did someone use an item on me? I couldn't even tell. And there are actually different like camera views here, or like camera angles. I know there's like an onboard view here, but I don't know how to enable it. That's not the hotkey right there though. That's just for speeding up the emulation. Oh yeah, there's also UFOs that fly by because this is basically Roswell. Okay, now what the hell is going on? Good, just keep on screwing up my laptop even more, OBS. Yeah, sure, I greatly appreciate it. Well, this would give me more time to check out the other camera angles. Okay, where's the other camera angle? Maybe it was L&R? I don't know. I'll have to check it again just after this, after the race ends. Oh my god, dude. Yeah, like my truck is like badly bruised and beaten. Yeah, and I did actually unlock Lost City. Well, the only other one I didn't use was Carolina Crusher, so yeah, I guess I could do Lost City as well. Yeah, so you have like a circuit race, then you have Rally and Monster X. Okay, I guess that emblem means I got first place on the track. I don't particularly care. Yeah, we'll try going to Lost City. There is at least one other camera angle I can select here, and that is the onboard view, which does return from the PC Monster Truck Madness games, but I'm gonna see if I can enable it here. Okay, yeah, that's the brake lights. What were the keys for the shoulder buttons here? I don't know. I haven't actually played a Game Boy Advance game in quite a while, much less on the Visual Boy Advance emulator. Oh, good lord. Yeah, these are the... Okay, get that little forklift out of the way. These sticky wheels look incredibly bizarre. You know, just coating the wheels in green slime. Yeah, no biggie. No big deal there. Oh yeah, also these this upgrade that makes your wheels gigantic. I have no clue what exactly that changes, though. Yeah, see, this is the upgrade right here. We all shrunk. It's basically the lightning from Mario Kart. Literally the same thing. They're just stealing ideas from Mario Kart. I don't understand why all of these like racers just have to copy and steal ideas from Mario Kart. Like, no originality here. No creativity. Also, this, yeah, that palm tree you can't actually knock down, so just try and avoid them. It's not like Midtown Madness where you can knock down certain ones. Actually, when I mentioned Rockstar Games a little while back, one of Rockstar Studios was actually responsible for developing Midtown Madness, because Angel Studios later rebranded to Rockstar North. Just thought that was interesting, but maybe I should save that for when I play Midtown Madness 2, which I've wanted to do for a while, because I already did a video on the first game. So maybe at some point in the future... Oh yeah, because this is a circuit race, there's actually going to be, like, 3 laps here. Yeah, what is kind of a bummer here is that you can't configure the amount of laps that you wish to race for. Monster Truck Madness 2 definitely had a lot more customization when it came to the races. Like, for instance, you could configure the amount of laps. I don't remember how many laps you could set. I think you could set maybe up to 9, but I don't fully remember, so don't quote me on that. And there were also various weather effects that you can enable too. Like, and there were also, like, day and night cycles as well. Like, you could have it- Holy crap, boys and girls! Yeah, that's not how physics works. Newton would be very disappointed. Also, look in the back of my truck. Like, my bumper is just falling off. Well, actually, no, that's my entire bumper. It's, like, sagging. Okay, well, anyway, physics anomaly aside. So, yeah, it had a lot more customization options. Like, you had different times of day and night that you could configure. You could be racing at either day, night, or even sunset. There were also different weather effects you could enable, like cloudiness, fog, dense fog, even rain and snow. And what was pretty cool about the snow in particular, no pun intended, is that it would cause every body of water on the track to freeze over, and then you could actually be racing on ice, and as you would expect, it was almost impossible to control because you had no friction. There was also a pitch black setting, which was basically dense fog, but you were driving at night, you know, for extra danger, only for pros, not for the faint of heart. But unfortunately, you don't get any of that in this game. I mean, the time of day that you race at depends on the track itself. Like, obviously here in the Mesa, like, the basically racing in the Grand Canyon over here, it's very clearly dusk, but it's unfortunate because you can't configure it. And I guess maybe I'm not surprised that there aren't that many customization options in this particular port, because, you know, this is the Game Boy Advance after all. Cartridges were not capable of storing as much space on them as CD-ROMs were, because that was the type of media that most PC games came on back then, and CD-ROMs were capable of storing a lot more space on them than cartridges, so that was usually the, go-to media for not just PC games, but also eventually consoles. So maybe a lot of those options were left out simply due to hardware limitations. Also, where did everyone even go? I just left everyone in the dust. They all just disappeared. See, this is why I don't understand why you can't choose the difficulty, because you could do that in the PC Monster Truck Madness. Why is it that I need to essentially unlock the other difficulties? That makes zero sense. Yeah, I'll do a race on Panorama, then maybe I might actually end the video after that. I'm also kind of disappointed by the game's announcer, because... Whoa, what the heck is this? Okay, we're just lining up in, like, a row. Oh, there's a plane coming! Yeah, hi, how are you doing? It's just like a... Oh my god, it looks like a World War I era plane. What the heck even was that? Okay, yeah, there. Get that pile of logs out of here. Okay, yeah, we're just racing in the... Yeah, we're racing in the forest. Okay, there we go. Somebody actually blew my ass up. Yeah, we're just racing along in the forest here. Racing in the great, wide-open wilderness. I dig it. We'll do this. Wait. Are there deer here that I can hit? Oh, you know what I think it is? It's because there's a spring. There's a spring upgrade that allows you to essentially bounce high up in the air. That's what that is. So it doesn't change the fact that the hill physics are a little bit odd. Wait, are there actually... Oh my god, are there actually deer that I can hit here? Hang on a second. I just want to take the time to actually look at this, because I need to make sure if this is actually what I'm seeing. Oh my god. Well, I can barely tell if this is what I'm seeing, but I think... Oh my god. Well, whatever it is, it just exploded, so... There I go, killing the wildlife. Provided that is wildlife, I can't even tell because everything's so damn pixelated. Oh god, yeah, it's just like on the run. It's like the background layer just looks like a wall of vomit. I've made that joke before, but it really does. Oh my god, dude, I'm sorry, but this just... I know the Game Boy Advance was a lot more limited in its 3D capabilities, but I'm sorry, this just looks like trash. It just looks really horrible. Oh, gee, oh, okay. Whoa, what is happening to the track? We were all just, like, sliding along there for a moment. This dimension's becoming unstable, guys. Everything is just warping before our very eyes. Holy crap. Okay, no, this is actually a rally track, I just realized, because we're going through stages. Okay, I get it now. I get it. But yeah, as I was saying before, because I'm just getting sidetracked by, like, absolutely everything that's going on, I'm disappointed by the announcer here, because one of the things I liked the most about Monster Truck Madness 2 was actually the announcer, because, you know, he had a lot of personality to him. I mean, he wasn't the funniest announcer in the world, but, you know, he had some amusing lines of dialogue. Like, he pretty much commented on every spectacular moment that occurred within a race. Like, for instance, if Executioner right here would get, like, massive air, sometimes he would respond to it with something like, "Here comes Executioner, duck and cover!" So, you know, I really did like the announcer. He could get a little bit obnoxious at times, but that was, like, one of my most favorite aspects regarding that game. And there is an announcer in the Game Boy Advance port of Monster Truck Madness, and I've probably been talking over him for, like, the entire video so far. But, yeah, I do not like him that much. Mainly because he barely has anything to say. Like, he has only two lines of dialogue, I'm pretty sure. Like, he can say, "Hey," or "What's going on?" And, I mean, that's pretty much it. He doesn't seem to have a sense of humor, or any personality for that matter. He doesn't say it in, like, the most overly exciting voice, like the, MTM2 announcer used to. But, I mean, he is a lot quieter than him, so if there's at least one thing I appreciate. I also wonder if I could go off one of the hills and hit that plane up there. I want to see if that's actually possible. Well, I'm not going to try and see, but I mean, if it happens, then I'll at least know. I can knock the plane out of the sky. It's flying pretty low here. I still don't know what these gigantic wheels actually do. Here, just blow everyone up in the back. Actually, that's probably why everyone's so slow to catch up to me, because I keep detonating them. Alright, well, that's it for that stage. Okay, I'm gonna try and see if I can get this onboard view to work here. I just looked at the controls, and it might be backspace. Let's just see if this works. Okay, yeah. So, oh wait, no, there's actually three different camera angles here. Okay, so yeah, you have the onboard dash cam, and then you have the very, like, far out view, which, oh god, it really messes with the other trucks in particular. They look, like, tiny compared to mine. But yeah, this, I mean, I'm still impressed by this, though. I mean, they at least tried. I can definitely say they tried. They made a pretty noble attempt here with the 3D renderization here. Because these kinds of games are not exactly common on the Game Boy Advance. Like it was capable of these kinds of graphics, but there weren't really that many games that tried taking advantage of the hardware. Like, I mean, most of the games that tried taking advantage of it were the racing games. Well, actually, I mean, Mario Kart Super Circuit even had, like, a somewhat 3D, like, graphical effect going on with it, a la Mode 7. Because, I mean, this was basically like SNES level graphics on a handheld system. But it was 32-bit, though, so, I mean, it was also capable of, like, PlayStation 1 or close to PS1 era graphics too, which, I mean, for a handheld at the time was very impressive, because, I mean, while this type of technology may look primitive today, I mean, this was the best kind of experience, like, the best kind of racing experience you could get on a handheld console at the time. Like, if you wanted to get a full 3D, or at least close to 3D racing experience on any handheld system, I mean, this was the one to go to. This system was the one to go to. Also, could I actually destroy that shed by colliding with it? I mean, I'm in a gigantic-ass monster truck. I could very easily be able to destroy, like a mobile home with this. It has to be possible. When I see that house come by again, I'm gonna have to ram right into it. Also, what I don't understand is that this is a giant monster truck, but you're telling me that I can't knock down trees with it. Here, I want to try screwing with the onboard dash cam for a little while here. Oh yeah, look at this. Oh yeah, the monster truck kind of disappears when it gets incredibly close to me, though. Wow, yeah, because you can't even see the wheels animating at all. Oh well, hardware limitations. I mean, what were you gonna do? What were you gonna do? Okay, right here. Oh my god, I can destroy it. Hang on a second. I wanna obliterate you into pieces. Oh, come on, I can't? Okay, I don't even care about beating this race anyway. Like, I stopped caring, like, 5 minutes ago. Well, actually, I didn't care to begin with, but okay, well, I guess maybe someone else already destroyed it. Oh, I can't collide with it. The best I can do is, like, shatter the windows on it, or, like, shatter the door. That sucks. That absolutely sucks. Oh, I thought I was gonna be able to fly into the water. Okay, well, I can destroy the outlook, or the outpost, or whatever the hell you call those things. Fine, I guess those ones are not exactly durable. I mean, they are made out of wood, after all. Oh, that looks like a paraglider, I think. How would I bounce up there and just knock your ass out with my giant monster truck? So, yeah, I don't really know what else to say about this port here, guys. I mean, an honest attempt was made to make this as viable as possible, or to, like, get the best possible Monster Truck Madness experience on a handheld console. They definitely try it, but honestly, I would still prefer the PC version over this anytime. It's not really the best, in my opinion. Not only that, there's not even any multiplayer. Like, you can't even play this with your friends. So the only people you can race against are the computer opponents, the AI. Not only that, but the AI was a lot more customizable, because you could actually select specific trucks that you prefer to race against. You could select from a list and then add them to the starting lineup. This port is definitely not bad, but in comparison to the PC Monster Truck Madness games, it's disappointing, to say the least. As a Game Boy Advance game, it's also a bit underwhelming. Like, no multiplayer mode? Are you serious? I mean, that couldn't have possibly been due to hardware limitations. Like, what were you thinking, Tantalus? Yeah, Time Attack and Race are not really that special, but I mean, the tracks do look nice at the very least, even if they're maybe a bit uninspired. I mean, one of the tracks in Monster Truck Madness 2 literally had you driving through a graveyard, and that was awesome. All the tracks in here are just, well, like normal environments. Definitely not the most original designs. And also, why can I not select which difficulty I want to play these tracks on? Like, I have to unlock the intermediate and professional versions of said tracks. Why can I not just select those difficulties already. Why is the unlock system structured so bizarrely in this game? I don't get it. I don't know, man. This port is just... It's underwhelming, at least. I wouldn't say it's abysmal, though. I'm genuinely impressed with what they managed to do with the Game Boy Advance's limited hardware. And unlike most 3D GBA games I've played, it doesn't run like garbage. Because as I demonstrated when I played the Game Boy Advance port of SSX 3, some of these games that tried to render 3D meshes and graphics on the Game Boy Advance, while the technology definitely looked impressive, it didn't run very well. SSX 3 on the GBA ran rather poorly, but I'm genuinely surprised by this one. The frame rate is actually pretty decent, and there's not that many frame drops anywhere either. We found a fully 3D racer on the Game Boy Advance that actually runs decently. So, other than that, guys, there's not much to this port at all. I would say just play the PC version instead. Specifically, play the PC version of Monster Truck Madness 2. I can't really tell you where to go get the Game Boy Advance version either. This never received any re-releases whatsoever, not even on the Virtual Console. I mean, this is still technically a Microsoft game, so I'm pretty sure Nintendo would not be interested anyway, or they wouldn't be able to get the legal rights to it. But then again, how exactly did this get released on the Game Boy Advance? I mean, you literally have a GBA game that displays the Microsoft Game Studios logo. I'm sorry, but something about that just makes me extremely uncomfortable. Like, how did this even happen? How did this collision of two vastly different worlds even occur in the first place? Like, I'm absolutely confused by this. Like, I'm confused by the mere existence of this game. This is a Microsoft-published game that somehow managed to get released on a Nintendo platform. Like, what timeline am I in? To put it simply, try finding a physical cartridge of this game. That's your best bet. Even then, I would still encourage you to just grab the PC version, if you can. This is a genuinely decent racing game, and I wouldn't go as far as to call it shovelware, but it pales in comparison to its home computer counterpart. I'm sorry, Tantalus Media, but you kinda dropped the ball with this one. But you know what they say, PC Master Race. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, as always, and I will see you in the next video I make. Later!